I had been living with Jónína for almost 10 years. But let me tell you, the fact that I had a same-sex partner did not cause any interest in Iceland, none at all. People in Iceland were concerned with my political ability, not my private life. And the Icelandic media did not mention my sexuality until the foreign media made a big deal of the fact that I had a female partner. But our personal journey has not been without pain. The story of my and Jónína's relationship is a tale of struggle. Strong emotions, conflict, self-accusations and worries. Worries about how it would affect our sons and my job in the ruthless world of politics. If we would dare to be open about our feelings. However, our story also shows that in the end, love can conquer all. And my wife will tell you more about that in a short while. But I would like to share one thing with you from my own bitter experience of being in the closet for 15 years. I regret not coming out sooner. I regret not making our relationship public many years earlier like Jónína wanted us to do. By waiting so long, we lost many years of our lives, years that could have been so much happier. Today, I know that the first step is to make peace with your own feelings and reject prejudice, both your own and other people's. You have to say to the whole world, I am what I am. Because when we have accepted ourselves, others will also accept us. And then, gradually, many doors will open up. When Jónína and I fell in love 31 years ago, Icelandic society was very different from how it is today. Way back in 1978, a very small group of young, brave people established a gay and lesbian association and started to fight for queer human rights. These people were the pioneers who paved the way and gradually changed the attitude of a whole society towards LGBT individuals. They carried on and never gave up. And in the end, this small group managed to change a prejudiced nation into an all-embracing society. In 1993, around 100 people took part in the first gay pride parade in Iceland. Just 100. But today, the parade is a very big annual event in Reykjavik with a crowd of around 100,000 people in the city center. That is almost one third of the total population of our country. Gay Pride in Iceland has become a family affair with grandparents, parents, siblings, children, and friends taking part to show their support for LGBT rights. Iceland is now one of the countries with the best legal rights for LGBT individuals. I am proud to say that during my time as Prime Minister, we passed a law for same-sex marriage, and on the day this new law took effect, Jónína and I changed our civil partnership into marriage. Our love survived all the obstacles that needed to be overcome, and later this month, on the 27th of June, we will celebrate our 6-year wedding anniversary. But our joy is mixed with sadness. It is difficult to enjoy a life of freedom and tolerance while so many of our brothers and sisters in other countries have to fear for their lives every single day. And one can ask, what is their crime? It is simply to love someone who happens to be of the same sex. Prejudice and ignorance are the main obstacles to sensible discourse about queer issues. That is completely intolerable in a world of ever-growing knowledge. Not to mention the pain of living all your life contrary to your true self. It is vitally important that every human being freedom and human rights are respected all over the world. No one should have to endure oppression, abuse, or lack of freedom, or even forfeit their life for claiming the fundamental human right of living in accord with their feelings. In many countries around the globe, this human right is not respected. Often by self-appointed leaders who think they alone know right from wrong. Leaders who reign in the name of some kind of orthodoxy or because of an enormous greed for wealth and power. Leaders who stop at nothing to make others accept their undemocratic stance, not caring an iota about human lives, health and happiness. Human rights organizations around the world have indeed made the world a better place. They have challenged extremist elements that far too often and far too wildly, cruelly deny queer people their basic human rights. It is terrible that in the year 2016, there are around 80 countries in the world that have some kind of anti-gay laws. And in some of these places, these laws are ruthlessly enforced. It is terrible that in some countries it is legal to send queer people to prison for the rest of their lives, sentence them to hard labor, whip them, or send them into exile. It is terrible that in up to 10 countries it is a capital offense to be gay, and that there are laws that sentence queer people to death by public stoning. The fight for queer human rights concerns each and every society in the world, just as the fight for gender equal rights. It is not a local issue, but a global issue. But even full legal rights are not enough, as we saw in the extremely tragic event in Orlando, Florida, a few days ago. Only education, open and honest discussions, and love can encourage understanding and dispel hatred. The fight for queer equal rights is not over until the whole world understands that the feelings of gays, lesbians, bisexual and transgender people are exactly the same as the feelings of heterosexual. Love is simply love.
It starts well. Hi, my name is Jónína. I just write books and I don't save economies like Jóhanna does. So, and I of course wrote a book about our story, and you can see the cover over there. It's called With Jóhanna, which means Jóhanna and I. And I chose this title extremely well. It was important to me because for 15 years, while we were in a secret relationship, it's the sentence that I most wanted to say. Everybody goes to the office or to the family gatherings, talking about their spouses, saying what you were doing over the weekend, what you're planning to do in the summer holidays, and I could never say, Johan and I are doing so-and-so, or planning whatever. So it was very important to me to say Johanna and I on the cover of the book. Actually, it's my... Thank you. It was book number 12. I have now written 15, 14 have been published, so it's one of many books, but it is extremely obviously important to me. And I want to tell you a little bit about what's inside.